To start with, I would like to take you back to a series of lectures you gave at the Yeltsin Institute in Yekaterinburg at the end of 2018 and the beginning of 2019, so roughly 2 years ago. The central thesis, as far as I understood, was that you noticed an important and remarkable shift in thinking among your countrymen and women as for their political wishes and orientation. You concluded that, in fact, the population and its ideas, its political ideas, were far more modern and developed than widely assumed, and that, therefore, the rift between the political structures in Russia and the ideas of the general public were getting larger. Could you, to start with, elaborate on that? What exactly were your findings then?
My findings were not based on my personal impressions or what is called anecdotal evidence, but on sociological data. I do not conduct surveys myself, but I use widely the data available from Russian polling institutions, sociological institutions. And I must say that quite recently we have a gold mine of new data being made available to us with the publication of the results of the seventh wave of World Values Survey, the global survey of values, which is conducted in by now almost every country in the world. The previous wave, the sixth, was from 2014 to 2017, and now the seventh wave had been published. And we see, according to these results, that the values of progress and self-expression, as opposed to the values of security, safety, and preservation, have gained momentum, have gained prominence in the minds of the Russian people as compared to the previous wave, as compared to the period of 2014. In Russia, inside Russia, I have paid attention to, for example, a series of focus groups conducted by the group of Sergei Belanovsky, a well-known Russian sociologist, the person who first brought focus groups into Soviet Union. He started his work back in Soviet times. And so he had a series of studies in various cities of Russia from spring 2018. And he showed, I think he was the first to show various points and various directions of change. Like, for example, a kind of disappointment with the foreign affairs, external affairs policy, or rather the lack of former concentration on foreign policy issues, which were predominant in the public mind, especially in the period of the so-called Crimean consensus, which was a very visible thing, a very real thing in Russian public opinion from 2014 to 2016. Starting 2016, we have seen a kind of erosion of this consensus or of this euphoria, as it's sometimes been called. But on the, I would say, on the tail now of this consensus, the parliamentary elections of 2016 were successfully conducted. Then started this erosion process, which kind of culminated in the public reaction to the pension age reform, which happened in the spring of 2018. This was a rather crucial point when we saw a sharp decline in the level of approval for the president, for the policy he conducts, for the agenda he is associated with, and also decline in trust and support for almost every public political institution. This process of decline has since been going on more slowly. Again, we had this moment of sharp decline. There was also a period of decline in the first half of 2018. Between then, there were these plateau moments, periods of more stability. 2020 has, of course, been a year like no other. Every social and political process has been affected by that.